that poem that the poet said. He says, إن لله عبادا فطنا تلقوا الدنيا وخافوا الفتنا نظروا فيها فلما علموا أنها ليست لحي وطنا جعلوها لجة واتخذوا صالح الأعمال فيه سفنا. And he says, Allah Ta'ala, verily he has some slaves. There's some of his slaves that he has that are intelligent. They're intelligent people. They divorced this dunya. And they feared the punishment of Allah. They divorced the dunya. And meaning their ta'aluk with the dunya is done. They got into a fight and they're not going to make up anymore. Right? They divorced this dunya. Which is what? It's not everything in the material world. Rather, it's everything in the material world that's not taking you any closer to your goal with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with your vision with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they're afraid of fitna, right? A fitna doesn't mean looking at good-looking girls. This has become like a meaning for this world. I don't know if it's like that in England, in America, as an old man. Oh, Aki, there's some fitna over there, you know? No, that's not what it means. The word fitna, right? A secondary meaning of the word fitna is a trial or a test or a tribulation. The primary meaning of the word fitna is what? It's the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That they feared the punishment of Allah, right? وَاتَّقُوا فِتْنَةً لَا تُصِيبَنَّ الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا مِنْكُمْ خَاسَةً. Fear from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, punishment, which will not only afflict those of you who are doing bad, but it will afflict everyone, evildoers and people who are good, all alike, right? It's not talking about a test, it's talking about the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah ta'ala has some very intelligent servants. They divorced the dunya, and they're afraid of Allah ta'ala's punishment. They looked at it, they looked at the dunya, they looked at it, and when they realized that it is not a place where any living person will ever have citizenship, right? It's not a watan for any living person. You'll never become. Are you alive? If you're alive, raise your hand, right? Are you alive? Raise your hand, right? So yes, you brothers, some people are not alive here, but you brothers that are alive, right? He says that if you're intelligent, you'll realize the fact that you're alive is a dalil that you'll not be here forever. It's a dalil that you're not a citizen. You're only here on a visa. You're just an immigrant. You're a boater like me, right? That it's not the homeland of any living person. They made the dunya into an ocean, right? And they made their good deeds, their good actions, like a ship that helps them cross through it. And there's something ahead of it, inshallah, right? That's what your vision is. That's what your long-term plan is. It explains to you what that thing is. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give all of us the tawfiq of being people who think about things instead of people who ignorantly wade through life and are happy with their ignorance. May He make us people who think about things. Every one of us has a vision that we can choose for ourselves and a goal that we can choose for ourselves and a way we can go about doing it. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us people who have a grand vision and a grand goal and not be spineless people who have paltry visions and paltry goals. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the tawfiq to fulfill them, because nobody's fulfilled anything except for through His power. And if He's doing it anyway, we may as well ask for whatever we want to ask for, right? Nobody has ever fulfilled anything except for through His power. And if He's the one who's doing it, we may as well ask for something more than something less, because we're not going to be the ones who are fulfilling it through our own labor or toil anyway. All we can do is seek it. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us people who don't wander through life drunk and aimless. Aimlessly rather, make us people who have a vision and have a goal, have something that we know we're going toward, so that even if we fall off the horse, even if we fall off the path that we know we're supposed to be on, if someone in that instant asks us, well, is this what you should be doing? May Allah ta'ala make us people who know that A, it's not, and B, who know what to do when it's time to turn back and get back on the horse and start moving back toward the path. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us people who, through His pure fadl, from His pure grace, allows us to fulfill such lofty goals, even though we don't have the power to fulfill them ourselves. May He, through His grace, through His fadl, and through His karam, and His nobility and generosity, may He make us among people who fulfill them anyway, despite our weakness and despite the lack of effort that we put forward toward it. وصلى الله تعالى على رسوله سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أجمعين. جزاكم الله خير for listening attentively, إن شاء الله.